the role, I think, because of her commitment to it.
To go on stage, it's a person. It's not only a dancer. Otherwise, why me? Why me on stage at that moment? It's really personal.
This year has already seen Guillem perform in Australia, Russia and Italy, with upcoming dates in Singapore and Japan. But when not touring, home is high up in the Swiss mountains.
Well, I guess I'm sensitive to this kind of environment, you know. Strong, beautiful, quiet, except from the for the water. There are some places where I feel comfortable, and this is one of them. It's good because it replaces you a little bit, you know, among these big things we are part of. It's not us only controlling, you know, I need to go there, I need to do that, I need to... No, here it's like, okay, you are not the one who decides all the time. Kuma! She's gonna smell terrible because she's... she found some... What kind of... No. Pousse-toi. C'est bien, reste là.
Okay, I don't have kids. I have dogs. It's fine. I didn't especially want a kid. Okay, no problem. Less problem, in fact. Not to have any kids. It's hard enough, you know, take care of yourself. Then on the top of that, if you have to raise kids, especially in the world we are living in, you know, I don't think they're going to have a nice life.
There are others that feel the same, and this cynicism springs from a recent environmental awakening that's offered a timely new focus for Guillem's unyielding passion. She's become an ardent supporter of a controversial marine protection society called Sea Shepherd. The group's founder, Paul Watson, is a hero to many.
Yeah, this is Paul Watson, nice to meet you.
But also the world's most wanted eco-warrior, famous for using direct action to expose and confront destructive whaling and fishing practices.
You're in a whale sanctuary and you're assisting in illegal activity. Remove yourself from these waters immediately.
With Sea Shepherd, it's a lot of action. They are on the spot, at sea, or where the problem is, to try to stop it. It's less communication, more action, and it's more like me. It's more what I think. You know, after a while, you have to do things. Otherwise, you can't just sit and wait for the things to be worse and worse.
She's come to Senegal in West Africa as part of a Sea Shepherd recce to discover more about the human and environmental impact of illegal trawler fishing in the country's waters.
The fishermen here, they can't compete with those huge boats who are taking everything, destroying life at sea and life here. The situation is quite critical.
Traditional fishing communities give Sylvie an insight into the scale of the problems.
Monsieur is the president of the artisan for the fishery, and he wants to say the problem they have is all the country who can't have the fish anymore in their own country, they come and they fish here. And in Senegal, it's the only thing they have to live, you know. And those people, they don't even come legally. They fish without license, without paying anything, and they just empty the sea. So it affects the whole population in a way that economically they can't survive. There is not enough fish for Africa, and there is not enough fish for Senegal. They said that they are reduced to fish the small fish instead of letting them grow. So they are fishing their future, basically.
In Illegal fishing causes other unwanted side effects, and the Senegalese Minister for Ecology is taking Sylvie to see a Spanish tuna trawler that's run aground just off the coast.
So the problem is that this boat hit the island here and is sinking, but there is some gasoil in it. So they're pumping the petrol out. And they also try to take off this net. It's an enormous net that doesn't make the difference between a tuna or a shark or whatever. It takes everything, kills everything. So it's better if it's out of the sea. So they're going to take care of it.
Here we have two tanks of gasoline. And we put here the first pump, and we take the gasoline, because we need that they don't go to the sea. It's difficult because here we have some waves, the boat is moving, and we have to go fast because the sea can be strong.
With limited resources at his disposal, the minister is hoping for sea shepherd's assistance in the future to help patrol and survey Senegalese waters.
Sea shepherd can help because they have a strong experience for survey. And we need to survey our sea because we have a lot of big boats who come in Africa, who take fish. So we need help for survey that. And I think that sea shepherd is strong for that. And we need that help.
MJ
is just putting up cables for the rest of
the Senegal's problems seem a long way from the bright lights of the international dance world. But back at Sadler's Wells Theatre in London, where Guillem's an associate artist, she's using her 6,000 miles away show to raise awareness and funds for Sea Shepherd's campaigns. Yet behind the scenes, the pressures of performance remain the same.
We were in New York, and Rudolph asked me, "Are you afraid before you dance, before you go on stage?" And I said to him, "Yeah, I am very afraid." And he looked at me with his, you know, little shiny eyes, and he said, "You'll see, it's going to be worse and worse." He was right. He was right. It's getting worse and worse.
I'm not going to be able to stay for long, and you have to undress.
But once I am on stage, it's over.
Her first performance of the evening is a duet called Rearray, created by American choreographer William Forsythe.
A lot of it is improvisation, so you can't let yourself go. You have to have the concentration. You have to use your brain, it's very tiring. Improvisation can be good one day and can be really terrible the other day. But it's interesting because it's really about the moment. And also it's very difficult because the music is not easy. You know, usually we get the music to help us. It takes a part of the body, you know, doing the things without really noticing it. But this one, we really have to la dompter. I don't know how you say that in English. To tame it.
Her final piece is a more intimate creation by Swedish choreographer Mats Ek.
The piece of Mats Ek, which is the solo called By, is different in the respect that it's a character that Mats imagined, more or less, being inspired by maybe me.
And I think he had a very precise idea of what this solo should tell. You know, it's a story of a woman. I feel that there is many women in that solo. There is someone that didn't really grow up. Someone who doesn't like to turn pages, but someone who has to turn pages. And some people see it as a little girl, you know, who had kind of a great time, a crazy time on stage. And some people see it as a woman facing age and time. I would say something like 48 years of reaction of a woman and experiences. I didn't need that solo to know that things have an end, you know, career have an end, life have an end, love story, they have all an end. I know that for a long time, but it's a nice way to put it. And also to face the things directly, sometimes it's much better than to put your head in the sand. Some moments, even if they are great, have to end at one point and to start something else. A transition has to be made, that's for sure. But I have other things, you know, the fact that I met Sea Shepherd or the association, and I'm really into those kind of things. It helps you also to take another direction. Yeah, I can't just stop, you know, and cry all the tears of my body because I'm gonna stop dancing. That's it. That's the way it is. And everything has a time. I did it the way I wanted all those years. You know, I'm still doing it for a few years the way I like it, the best I can. But I know that I want to do it that way and not going downhill and trying to just, you know, get a grip on that hill. I prefer to use it to go up again, to use it as a springboard. Voilà.